Until you have the spirit of wisdom and revelation, you'll be stranded in your journey on earth. You will be stranded in your journey on earth. As far as you don't have the spirit of revelation and wisdom, you'll be. And I'm glad the Bible calls it a spirit. I'm so glad it calls it a spirit. So if it is a spirit, go for it. You can get it. He didn't even call it two different spirits. He called it one spirit. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. And the knowledge of him. That the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. If you don't have it, you are stranded. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. I am trying to prepare your heart because you are going to pray for that spirit. Everything I'm doing is giving you one prayer topic. Lord, today, give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you, that the eyes of my understanding may be enlightened. Enough of reading the Bible like novel. Let the heavens open. Give me that spirit. That is why we are here today. That's the first step to the flight we are taking this night. Give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation. The spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. If you don't have it, prophecy will help you. All this, what is God saying? No. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. That's all you need. That's all you need. And I'm so glad to announce to us here today that if anybody here can grab that spirit, let's close the service. That's what you need for your next level. That's what you need for a flight with God. The spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. Maparo Zuzia. Kiko Pratis. And here today, everyone that will open their mouth to pray, you are going with that spirit. You see, we are in a time in the church where people no more have spiritual hunger. The only thing that brings them to church is the hunger for physical things. No, this scripture I am reading to you today from Ephesians, I fasted with it. Lord, give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation. And when it came, from that day, every scripture grants me access. You, no matter your color, you are stranded as a child of God without the spirit of wisdom and revelation. Put it on the screen again before we start to pray. Now, listen. I want you to hunger for it. I want you to hunger for it. A woman was quarreling with the husband every day. Every day quarreling. Every day. To the extent the husband drove her out. They divorced. And she now went to church one day. The pastor was preaching. The pastor was not even talking of marriage. The pastor quoted Genesis chapter 3. As the pastor quoted, she opened. And the pastor was reading. What happened? He says, Eve, what happened? He says, the serpent. And God began to curse them. See what God said. He said, you, the woman, because of what you have done, thy desire shall be to thy husband. That was what the woman had. The woman was not preaching on marriage, but revealed truth jump out. As the man read that place and passed, all the woman was not hearing. If you're a woman, your desire shall be for your husband. If you're a woman, your desire shall be for your husband. You cannot be desiring on that thing if not your husband. No matter what you have, until you have your husband, you don't have anything. The woman went back to the husband, kneeled down, forgive me. 15 years marital crisis broken. Spirit of wisdom and revelation. That is the spirit that communicates the word to you to suit you. And you are going to pray, Lord, give it to me today. Give it to me today. I may be talking on yam. And some other person may be hearing beans. Because that is the area of his need. You need that spirit. Put it on the screen. Ephesians 1. Let's start from 16 for better understanding. Cease not. That's Paul talking to the Ephesian church. Okay, take it down, take it up again to 15. Yeah. Wherefore I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto all the saints. Verse 16. Cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers. That's Paul praying for the church. Lord, he was not praying for car for them. Excuse me. Paul was not praying that God will bless them with a car and bless them with a wife and husband and children. No. Look at the kind of prayer he was praying for them. Prayer for spiritual virtue. Prayer for spiritual virtue. I hope you know, in the book of Matthew chapter 5, the Bible says, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after what? Righteousness, for they shall be filled. All this hunger for bread and butter, that's why nothing has happened. You know what the Bible says? In Psalms 103 and verse number 7, he made known his ways unto Moses, his acts to the children of Israel. Now hear me. Who was Moses and who was the children of Israel? Moses was producer. Children of Israel were consumers. He was producing miracles. These ones were busy consuming. So what does Moses have that made him a manufacturer of miracles? He had the ways of God. These ones had the acts of God. So which is superior? The ways of God. Revelation is superior to bread and butter. Go for revelation. When you get revelation, you get every other thing. When you get revelation, you get every other thing. All this, Lord, give me. No. When you know how to produce it, you never harass anybody. You never have a sleepless night again when you know how to make it happen. And that's why we are here today. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The spirit of wisdom and revelation. Oh my God, you need it. Lord, give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, that the eyes of my understanding might be opened. Baligarosi atara. And that ends every struggle. That terminates every frustration. And you move into your next level. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Can you take a look at Luke 24? And verse 44-45. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me. Verse 45. Somebody watch this. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. He was with them. Four of you, stand quickly. Follow me. These guys are not smart. He was with them, talking with them after his resurrection. They were chatting, discussing on the way. My friend, come here, follow me. They were talking. You know what they were talking? Have you heard of that man? One man that came here and he said that he's going to die and after 3 days he's going to resurrect. They were talking with him. They were talking. He said, some great things has happened in this city. Something we have never seen before. And he was not listening to them. He said, what? Within him, he was like, are these not the people I told? I was with them and I told them that such a thing will happen. So even when I was telling them, they didn't understand. Then in verse 44, look at this. Verse 44. He now said, and he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you. This thing happening now is what I told you. While I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerning me. I told you. Yet, look at, even while he was telling them there, they didn't understand. See what the Bible now said in verse 45. Then open ye their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. Every blocked understanding here. To the scripture, today, I decree, be open in the name of Jesus. You know, somewhere in the book of Psalm 119, I don't know whether it's 164 now or whatever, but Psalm 119, the psalmist was talking. The psalmist prayed a prayer. He said, Lord, give me understanding that I may live. Give me understanding that I may live. That I may live. So without understanding, you're a dead man. Psalm 119 verse 144. Lord, give me understanding that I may live. The righteousness of thy testimonies is everlasting. Give me understanding and I shall live. So without understanding, life will be hard. Hard. To live will be difficult. You need understanding of scriptures. Enough of Lord, give me bread, give me butter, give me bread. No, when you have understanding. Now listen, I came to Abba with nothing. Please, I am saying this with every sense of humility to God and glory to God. I came to Abba with, when I say nothing, nothing. But I had understanding. I had understanding. I had understanding. When I hear people talk as if they are the only ones suffering, I just laugh. The reason why your suffering has continued is because you lack understanding. The know-how. The know-how. Somebody say know-how. The know-how. That's what they call. It's called the know-how. The know-how of a thing. That's understanding. The Bible says that the labor of the foolish wearieth them all, because he knoweth not how to go to the city. He does not know how to go to the city. If you don't know your way to Owerri, you end up in circles, running in circles. If you don't know your way to Port Harcourt, you just end up in circles. So I like you to crave for the spirit of wisdom and understanding. I like you to crave for it. And the knowledge of him, not understanding of your fellow human being, not understanding of the market, understanding of the word of God, granting you access to how to make things happen on your own. When I say rise up, the next voice that should be heard should be yours. In prayers, Lord, give me the spirit of wisdom and understanding in the knowledge of you, that the eyes of my understanding might be opened. Stretch your right hand toward this altar right now, and the next voice I must hear must be your own, and that voice may be very loud. I decree today that as we partake of the communion, whatever that covers your eye from seeing beyond the letters in scriptures, that force goes off your eye in the name of Jesus. Now, what you are carrying is the solution to every problem of your life. All you need is insight. We call it what? Insight. We call it insight. Insight. Le broche en gradizo. When you look at an ocean at the surface, all you see is water. But when you go deep, when you have insight, you can see oil inside. Come on now, am I talking to someone here right now? Right now on the news, they said they just discovered oil in Lagos. Lagos is now an oil-producing state. Can I tell you something? It has been there all this while. It has been there! Did God recreate the world? Did God recreate the world? It has been there! But no insight. Without insight, you will be dying with treasures around you. You will be dying with treasures around you. You will be dying, suffering, going through stress with treasures around you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. What excites me and my greatest hunger in life is the hunger for spiritual things. I know somebody say bread, butter, Lord, 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 house, Lord, car. Nonsense. When you lay hold of the spiritual, you have held the physical. It's as simple as that. It is that simple. There was a time I had to fast. Not as a pastor. I mean as a brother in the Lord. As a bro. I was fasting. What was my fasting for? Lord, I want to hear your voice. I want to know how to hear your voice. Some people don't have such a hunger today. No hunger. Rather than go to somebody and ask the person, so what is God saying? And the man will now mix God's own and his own and give to you. In case you don't know, there are mixtures. Kenneth Hagin said, most prophecies is 80% flesh, 20% God. Most prophecies is what? Yes, the man has been able to tell you one or two things from God. The rest, flesh, is adding his own. Adding his own. Adding his own. Adding his own. I have a strong hunger for God. And that hunger is back. Seriously back. I said that scripture I'm asking you to pray with many years ago before I became a pastor. I fasted with it. Lord! Kabusha diabata. Spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you. That the eyes of my understanding might be enlightened. Anybody wants that spirit right now? Huh? It is not a gift. It's a spirit. It is not what? Go to 1 Corinthians 12. You will see where they mention all the nine gifts of the Spirit. Revelation in the Word is not there. Come on now. I'm having the best of time here. Revelation in the Word is not there. It is not the gift of the Spirit. It is a spirit. It is a spirit. Paul prayed that prayer for the Ephesian church. I am praying that prayer for you today. That the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened. That the Lord will give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please don't forget. Insight in scriptures is superior to foresight into the future. Excuse me, I don't know what you're looking for. I don't know what you're looking for. If you don't have any hunger for spiritual things, like I was preaching on Sunday, I think so, you know, when I was trying to define, you know, the topic of the first service, I was still trying to do my introduction. I said, vision. It's what creates the atmosphere of your life. Vision is what decides your acceptance or rejection. Anywhere. Because you will only attract and will only be attracted to the people who are tied to your vision. And that was what brought about that teaching on connection. And then I said, you meet a doctor, who and who do you expect for him to meet? Sick people. You meet a lawyer, clients that have legal cases. You meet a teacher, students. Now, and I said, you meet a pastor. And some of you say everybody. It cannot be everybody. A pastor is not meant to meet with everybody. No. A pastor is only meant to meet with people who have spiritual needs. When you are sick, not you, in Jesus' name. Amen. Because I'm highly anointed now. When somebody is sick, there are two things to it. It's either he goes to a medical doctor to give him physical attention, or he goes to a man of God for spiritual attention. And you're going to a man of God is that you have seen it, that need can be met spiritually. That's why you don't have business meeting everybody as a pastor. There are people that come here and I tell the person coming to tell me somebody's looking for you. I tell them I don't want to see the person. Simple. I have no time. Church is a gathering of people who have spiritual needs. You may have a money problem. If you want to fix a money problem, you go to the bank. Or to a stockbroker or whoever to fix your problem. But when you have a money problem and you come to church, it's a simple way of saying, I see my problem as a spiritual need. So give me a spiritual solution to it. It's as simple as that. That's why I don't have any time of running around politicians. Politicians for what? A politician can come to me if he sees his spiritual need for what he's doing. So pray for me. I want to win. I pray. Okay. I have a case. Can you cancel me? And I give you counsel. Running around with them with no business with them is a waste of time. The atmosphere is too charged. Between now and Sunday, wherever I'm pointing my hand to now, that's where God is going. Between now and Sunday, I declare, you are having a testimony that will blow your own mind. It's as simple as that. Now, in my prayers this afternoon, just to come and, I had a word from the Holy Ghost. He spoke this word very clearly into my ear, very clearly, like you are hearing my voice now, like the voice of a human being in my prayers this afternoon. He said, it is word practice that gives birth to word profit. He said, go and tell them. It is word practice that gives birth to word profit. And then he gave me the scripture. It is word practice that gives birth to word profit. Praise God. I can hear you. Praise God. Please, can you come alive? Praise God. There are so many people in church today who complain that the word does not work for them. They complain that the word does not work. But I want to show you the missing key or the missing link. In Hebrews chapter 4 verse 2, Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 2, you can look at the screen. Please, I hope that sometimes after service you go back to your note. Huh? Especially now that we're using the screen for scriptures, it may just disconnect you from your Bible. Now look at it. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that had it. So These are two different bodies. They are two different entities. He said, the word preached unto us is the same word preached unto them. Anybody here with me right now? The word preached. The man that shared a testimony had the same thing that the man that did not share any testimony had. Anybody here with me right now? I don't like your head to be moving like this. Your head should just be steady now. The word preached. Please put it on the screen one more time. For unto us was the gospel preached. Unto us the gospel was preached, as well as unto them. Oh. But the word preached did not profit them. In other words, they didn't get anything out of the preaching. Why? Because they did not mix the word with faith as they had it. This afternoon, it was like thunder on my bed, because my knees were down and my body was on the bed. He said, go and tell them, it is the word practiced that gives birth to word profit. Now watch it. The word of God is for information and application. The word of God is for information and application. As I am talking now, you are receiving information of the word. But if it ends here, the word will not produce. That's what it means. Hello? Hello, sir. I can hear you. Hello? If all you do is to receive the information, then you will have nothing to show for it. The word preached. The word preached. Did not profit them. I like the way that grammar was constructed. Did not profit them. So my prayer is that you are not the one it will not profit. Amen. It did not profit them. So it will profit us. Amen. That's why if you check very well today, the preaching of the gospel has gone to the other side, the other level, where we never preach to entertain. There are gospel entertainers, in case you don't know. Those are the motivational speakers. That as you talk, they are shouting, speak on! Yes, sir! Talk to me! Baboku! Yes! Tell them! Hello? That's gospel entertainment. Jump up! Shout hallelujah! Shout. Today, when we come to church, we sit down, not just to hear, to assimilate. To do what? Because, listen, you can shout off anointing. You can shout off revelation. Too much noise. Today you go to places where the word is being preached. Everywhere is as quiet as where the president is giving a presidential speech. Why not? It is the word of the great king. So that we receive assimilation. Put that scripture on the screen again. Everybody, let's read together. I want to go. For unto us was the gospel preached. as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that had it. Now hear this. Watch that statement. Put it on the screen. Put it on the screen, please. Just put it there. I'd like you to put your eyes there. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well unto them. Somebody say information.
Information.
So, when the gospel is preached, what you are given is what? Yeah. Now, watch this. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that had it. Now, the first group received what? Information. The second group, one thing is missing among the two bodies. One applied what he had. The other did not apply. So, the preaching of the gospel is for information and application. How? James chapter number 2 and verse number 17. It said, because they did not mix it with faith. So somebody will now ask, what is faith? I thought I had faith. I thought I had faith. What is faith? Because if you ask anybody now in the church, the next thing they'll say, I have faith, I have faith, I have faith, I have faith. What is faith? Put it on the screen. Everybody read that scripture, want to go. Even so, faith, if it had not works, is dead, being alone. So what is faith? Faith is the application of the word. Until what you hear graduates to action, you don't have faith. Faith is not muscle parade. Say, look at me, I have faith. See me. No. Faith is not muscle parade. No. Faith is the application of the word. You hear it, you don't stop in hearing it, you apply it. Now that young man that was talking to me after Wednesday service said, after the prayers we prayed here, he still got home to pray. He still got home to do what? But some of us got home to sleep. I think you are the one that told me that for a long time you've not had an all night in your house. But after that Wednesday, you had an all night. It is not to be heard, it is to be applied. The word you hear that you don't apply will not produce. And you keep complaining. I think they told us. I thought they prophesied. I thought. The word is to be applied. People of God, since 1998 till now, I have been a word practitioner. I have been in the business of word practice. Some people say, can I pay that to 5 naira? Is it your own? God said, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, let them meet in my house. He said, the tithe is mine. The tithe. If I give you my handkerchief, and I say, give it to me. Did you do any great thing for me? You gave me my thing back. God said, 10% of all your income belongs to me. Even before you get the money, he said that 10% in it is my own. So when you give him what belongs to him, you didn't do him any good. Hey, come on. You know, some people give, pay tithe in church and they pose. We just pay tithe there. You know, just make sure the ministry is going forward. You can hold it. And you still see the work go up while you go down. Because he said, bring the tithes into the storehouse that they will meet in my house. He said, if you don't do it, you are under a curse. And what is a curse? Empowerment to faith. Simple. Since 98, I heard of tithe. I have been practicing it. It will even shock you now. I didn't even know I would be talking on tithe. See tithe. This one. This is tithe. My tithe. How much tithe? As careful as 1,000. I've tithed and tithed even 100,000. He's not hearing it. He's doing it. If not, it will look like God is lying. And he said, I am not a man that I should lie. If not, it will look like this thing is not working. This thing works. I've had some of my sons in ministry come to me and say, you see, we're doing some serious preaching and doing some fastings, heavy weight fastings, and yet nothing is happening. We don't know the problem. The first thing, immediately you start talking like a pastor, the first thing I'll just tell you, you're not a tither. And that's the truth. All of them are proved, don't tithe. All. Preaching for 2 hours does not guarantee prosperity. No. How can somebody wed after wedding? No tithe. You didn't tithe. Do you know that the money you got in during your wedding is the first income of the family? Every other money was the money you made as a single. The woman made as a single. The man made as a single. That day you were dead, even if it's 2 naira, that is the first income of the family. And listen, I don't know why I'm talking on this evening. Can I tell you the truth? And that is the humbling truth that we make, even if you are not yet married, you'll be conscious of this as you get married. Do you know why Adam and Eve were chased out of Eden? Some people say because they ate the forbidden fruit. Let me tell you the truth today. It's because they ate their tithe. God said, this place is called Eden. Everything you need in this life, I've supplied it here. Just all you do is maintenance job. Dress it and keep it. Dress it and keep it. And then he said, one law. Of every fruit and tree of this garden, you may freely eat. But this one, thou shalt not touch. And the day they touched it, they were chased out of Eden. Everyone that touches his tithe gets out of his Eden. No matter the blessing God gives you, there is a part of it reserved for him. If you touch it, he closes the door. I've been a what with since 98. I've never had a better last year. Like you say now, you say, I think last year was better than this year. I've never since 98. Every new year has been a plus because I caught it. I was telling that my son. I said, listen, no matter your need, give God his 10%. I don't even know what we're talking about. He came to tell me he was trying to go from the office. I said, okay, how are you? Fine. So we're just talking. I said, why? Fine. I said, okay, listen. No matter your need, never touch your tithe. Some people who look as if they are ahead of you today, you'll be surprised tomorrow you overtake them. It has been discovered, until you tithe consistently for 4 years, you will not change financial level. Consistent, not tight for 6 months, you now break for 2 months. Consistently 4 years. Once you tight consistently 4 years without prayers, the atmosphere of your finances will just change. Another 4 years, sure. Another 4 years, sure. We've been doing it since 98. 98 and now is some time. And you can't tell me I'm in the same level. Where my first tithe was 15 francs. It has no naira equivalence. It has no naira equivalence. I was in Cotonou then. That 15 francs was even 30%, not 10%. I'll see where we are today. The practice of the word guarantees your future. Please don't deceive yourself. All this coming to church, copying notes, your notes will not make you notable. It is after copying you go and do it. Whatever you hear from God's word, whatever you know, whatever you discover, it is for practice. It is for practice. It is for practice. Please, it is for practice. If not, it will look like this thing is not working. From the day I had a prophet offering, I have been addicted to it. Hebrews 7:7. Luke 6:38 says, "Give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaking together, and running over shall." Luke 6:38. What did he say? Give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, and shaking together, and running over shall men give into your. Who will give into your bosom?
Men
or angels? Some of you are expecting angels to bring money. Men are the people to give into your bosom. But here the revelation that turned me on. In Hebrews 7:7. Hebrews 7:7. And without all contradiction, the less is blessed of the better. In other words, you must look for your superior spiritually and be given to him. And then God will compel those around him to give to you. That was how I delved into the revelation and practice of prophet offering. Prophet offering. I don't need an altar call for that one. The word is for practice. Help me tell your neighbor, the word is for practice. This is for practice. Young man, I know. He said, if he comes to any service, you will not see him with pen, you will not see him with paper, you will not see him with anything. But if he goes out to preach whatever you preach, he will preach more than you. He can cram. He's a good orator, but no practice. So he's doing all the preaching, and yet there's nothing to show for it. Rather, they are putting in gimmicks to make it work. Now hear me. Until you do the word, you don't have faith. Because the word preached did not profit them because they did not mix it with faith. And the Bible says, hey, tell us. Show me your faith without your works. There must be a corresponding action to show that you have faith. Praise God, somebody. Now hear me. Between now and Sunday, somebody who will go to mix the word with faith, which is action, you are coming back with a testimony. Coming back with a testimony. This church tithes. That's why we don't have a closed heaven. How can we have a closed heaven? We're not struggling. Now here is a summary. There are prophetic verdicts and there are prophetic instructions. Prophetic instructions are released to draw faith from you. Hello? Look up here and watch this. Watch this now. Watch this. In the name of Jesus, you will prosper. Prophetic verdict. A decree. Now, prophetic instruction. You will prosper if you. Prophetic instruction. So the prophetic instruction is to do what? Draw faith from you. Once you obey that instruction, you have exercised faith. You have put God to commitment. You have committed God to act. Can I ask you a question? How many of you know the man called Naaman in the Bible? Naaman, you have the story? Huh? Who was Naaman? Was he a leper? Praise God. Naaman was a leper, and he went to a prophet by information. By what?
Information.
Talk to me now. By what?
Information.
Yeah, a girl told him that there's a prophet somewhere. Two of us? Faith cometh by?
Yeah.
So he heard, and then he went to the man. That's action. Two of us? First action. And then when he got to the man, he was expecting the prophet to come out and lay hands. What did the prophet do? The prophet said, hey, go and tell him he should go to a river and dip himself. How many times? Okay, now somebody talk to me, because I can see you know the story already. When he got to River Jordan and dipped himself the first time, was he cleansed?
No.
Second time, was he cleansed?
No.
Third time, was he cleansed?
No.
Fourth time, was he cleansed?
No.
Fifth time, was he cleansed?
No.
Sixth time, was he cleansed?
No.
When was he cleansed? Seventh time. Until your obedience is complete, God does not respond to you. Until your obedience is complete, God does not respond to you. Until your obedience is complete. Partial obedience is equal to disobedience. If he has stopped at the third time, no cleansing, no healing virtue will flow. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Whew. God sees obedience to his word as faith in action. God sees obedience to his word as faith in action. When prophetic instructions are given and obeyed, then there is a mixture that gives birth to prophets in the world. Acts 16 and verse 30. As we begin to round up. Acts 16, 30. Look up. Beautiful scripture. You know that story. Hello. Paul and Silas in the prison. Hello?
Hello,
and while in the prison, they began to sing and to pray, and the prison doors were open. Am I talking to somebody here right now? When the man that was the prison warder, the prison guard, when he discovered that the doors were open and maybe Paul and Silas has escaped, the man took his sword to kill himself, and Paul exclaimed from the prison, do yourself no harm, because we are still here. By the time the man went in with light and saw the both of them, he was torn. You know what the man did? The man asked a question. As he brought them out, he said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? Immature Christians pray, Lord, do it. Mature Christians say, Lord, what do I do to have it? What do I do to be saved? There is something to do to get what you want. Lord, show me that in your word. I'm not just shouting as if God is deaf. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, are you still there? Are you still there? Are you still there? It's 7 o'clock. Oh, what do we do? Time is going. Lord, no. The man asked them, what must I do to be saved? What must I do to be saved? So what was he expecting? A prophetic instruction. Huh? Come on now, talk to me. Hello?
Yes.
And that instruction was given to him immediately. Look at the next verse. And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. Now, If they had told him, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and that shall be saved in thy house, and he says, I will not. Will he be saved?
Yes.
No matter how you pray. Look, go to 32. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and all that were in his house. The next verse. And he took them to the same hour of the night, and washed their scribes, and was baptized, he and all his straightway. The word is to be practiced. John chapter 2 verse 5. Very important. This is to cure the frustration in the body of Christ. So many people are now frustrated. I go to church every day. Oh, and nothing is happening. No, no, no. Listen. You cannot be doing the word and be frustrated. They lacked wine in their marriage. No wine. Lack came. Poverty came. Hey. Oh, Lord. Will you be there and we die in our poverty? Simple. I think I need to start from verse 2. Let's do from verse 2. Now there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee and so on, and both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. Yeah? Verse 4. And when they wanted wine. Hello?
Hello, sir.
I preached from there in a church somewhere there, and one of their deacons said to me, I've been in church a long time, I've not seen that. Put it there again. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they have no wine. Excuse me. When they wanted wine. My question is, that time they wanted wine, was Jesus there?
Yes.
Huh? God can be with you and you will die in poverty. God can be living in your house and you'll be dying of your suffering. Jesus was there in the marriage and he had luck. Yes, the next verse. Jesus said unto her, woman, wait, go back. Yes. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they have no wine. That's prayer. Lord, we are in lack here. We need something. We need money. We need the money for rent. We need money for school fees. We need this. We need that. Oh, Lord, we need clothes. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus told his son, they need wine. Now hear what Jesus said. Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? My hour is not yet come. Please listen. The meaning of what Jesus said was, my hour to perform a miracle has not yet come. Because it is recorded clearly in the Bible, in that same chapter, John 2 verse 11 and 12, that this is the beginning of miracles that Jesus did. This is the first miracle he ever did when he stepped on the earth. The first miracle. So at that moment, he was telling them, I am not yet ready. By divine timing, it's not yet time to start the miraculous. The mother looked at him. Quickly, go back to that verse. The mother looked at him. Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? My hour has not yet come. Ah, your hour has not yet come and we are dying here. His mother said unto the servants, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. And that was it. The miracle, he said that the time for it has not come. The miracle was born. If you are waiting for God's time, you will waste. Commit him with his word. If you are waiting for God's time, you will waste. Commit him with his word. And you have what you want. I thought he said that his hour has not come. The mother said, I know you. Servants, don't talk to him again. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. And when he had it, he knew he was committed. He now said, pour water into the water jars. And as they poured water into the water jars, without prayers, there is no place it is recorded that he prayed. Without prayers, the water turned to wine. When you obey God, prayer becomes useless. You know, all this breaking head up. Lord, do it. Hold up. As if God is deaf. Did he pray? Immediately, Jesus heard. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. He said, these people are ready to mix the word with faith. So because you are ready to mix the word with faith, take your prophet. That was it. And then in verse, that should be verse, can you go to verse 9 and let me look at it, what is there? And look at that. When the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine, and knew not whence it was, but the servants which drew the water, the governor of the feast called the bridegroom, verse 10, and said unto him, Every man at the beginning doth set forth good wine, and when men have well drunk, then that which is worse. But thou hast kept the good wine until now. You kept the best till now. The word will give you the best. It doesn't matter what anybody thinks he has. The word will give you the best. Now stretch your hands. I want to make a prophecy now that is very heavy. It's going to bless you. I can't see your hand up. And now the next thing I will hear is your voice. Now hear this. Today is the 18th day of May 2016. January has passed. February passed. March passed. April passed. This is May. And we're going to June. June is the last month of the first half. Now hear this. To everyone that will commit themselves to the practice of the word, I decree. Hear my voice well and let me hear your voice as you respond in faith. I declare, whatever you have seen between January and now, what you will see from June to the end of the year will be better for you. By word practice. Word practice. Word practice. Word practice. I give you praise, Jesus. Thank you, Father. So beautiful out here, I tell you. Now here is, God has given us a prophetic word for the year of more. John 15 verse 2. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away, and every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruits. But you see, most of us may never experience the more prophetic agenda until we commit ourselves to the more prophetic instruction. And what is the more prophetic instruction? John 15, 16. John 15, 16. Everybody read. Everybody, everybody, I want to hear your voice. One to go. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. So what is he saying? I have promised to give you more. Whatever you ask, I will give. But on one instruction, you go and bear fruit, and that your fruit will remain. And what is that fruit? Soul winning. You must be a soul winner. People think you only need to pray for God to answer. No, there are other conditions. Soul winning is one. Prayer alone does not guarantee an answer. There are other conditions tied to answer prayers. And one of it is soul winning. Put it on the screen. Verse 16. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and ordained you that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain. Don't, I didn't just say win a soul. Make sure as you win the soul, it remains in the church. That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. So, the ball is in our court. You want God to hear your prayers? You want more? Then go and bear fruit. Bear fruit. And let your fruit remain. He said, whatever you ask the Father in my name, I will give it to you. Hello? I can hear you. Hello? Just like that man said, what shall I do to be saved? Now, what shall I do to have more? What shall I do for my prayers to be answered? Go and bear fruit. And that your fruit may remain. Word practice. Word practice. Word practice. Word practice. Word practice. And now hear me. He will hear your prayers. Yeah. I didn't hear somebody's voice. I said he will hear your prayers. Yeah. Did anybody receive it tonight?
Yes, sir.
Are you blessed tonight?
Yes, sir.
Somebody say,
I receive it.
One young man told God to give him a job. Lord, give me a job. Graduate. No job. Everywhere he applied, no job. And then he saw that scripture. That's why we prayed that prayer. that God will give you the spirit of what? Wisdom. And what? Revelation. In the knowledge of him. That the eyes of your understanding may be what? Enlightened. He saw that scripture. He said, ah. He said, if I bear fruit, whatever I ask, you will do. He went for soul winning. What 15 souls to Jesus. Can you believe this? A company he did not apply to call him. Sometimes we hear testimonies and we think they are lies. I was with one of my daughters in the Lord who was here with me yesterday. She should be in church on Sunday because I told her to come for something. Yesterday she was telling me, I knew her as an evangelist that has a ministry. Now I saw her as a banker. I said, how come you're a banker? Hey, he said, Daddy, you don't understand. He said she finished OND, went for BSc. After BSc, went for youth service and decided just to apply for jobs in case. Before she would go back to her ministry. She applied to some banks. Nobody called her. And now see how God works. When she has lost hope of a job, she was where she was one day. IBTC Chartered Bank called her for an interview. She got there. I said, you saw people call me. I didn't apply here. They said, somebody who worked in the place where you applied is now working here and mentioned you. It's not hard for God to bless a man. 15 souls that this guy was talking about won and went to God. He said, whatever I ask. I won souls. The heavens opened. Company didn't apply, called him. As he got there, finished the interview, they said, start work. That was it. Started work immediately with the first salary. Tears don't move God. Faith moves God. Stop crying. Go and obey. Rise to your feet.
We believe this message has blessed you. If you want to give your life to Jesus, say this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I believe you are the Son of God and that you died and rose again. I receive you now into my heart to be my Lord and personal Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for coming into my heart. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.